Is now in session. Knuckle up, gentlemen, because here's a true legend in the ring, William Regal. Call him the man's man, call him the old villain, or just call him Mr. Regal. Emphasis on Mr. Few people have the experience, the technical skill, or command the respect across our business that William Regal does.
One of the very few people in WWE who you can genuinely say has done it all.
And then you have Roderick Strong, a superstar who is a true hard worker and has developed a wealth of in-ring knowledge. There's no cutting corners when you're squaring up with a competitor of his caliber.
I have to say you're right. Few guys can say they put in the same hours as Strong has honing his craft. You don't become the messiah of the backbreaker overnight.
Oh, kick right in the gut.
Backbreaker.
Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off.
When you're taking on Roderick Strong, how do you counter his incredible conditioning, which lets him keep going at top speed deep into a match?
You need to attack Strong's core and try to strip him of that advantage. The more hurt you can put on his back and abs, the harder it'll be for Strong to catch that second win.
And all of Strong's wealth of in-ring knowledge couldn't prevent that attack.
Yeah, Regal just used his technical skill to pick him apart.
Oh my God, right over the top and hit hard. And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside.
Seated drop kick.
Strong avoids damage.
Wards off that offense from Regal.
Three. Oof, nasty looking inverted suplex.
Four.
Double underhook.
Nice butterfly suplex.
Under the ropes now.
Oh, God.
He's absorbed some damage already. Yeah. Jumping knee strike.
I like that.
Oh, Is this really going to happen?
And the rope forces the break.
Great effort, though. Really just laying it in.
Well, he knew what was coming.
Just one step ahead.
One shot at the cover. Raising the arm before one.
Maybe that was just to keep his opponent off balance.
Cross the shoulders, up and...
Gotcha.
What an attack from the Messiah of the Backbreaker.
Precarious position for both superstars.
Oh, gosh.
Back suplex right out of the apron. And the momentum's clearly against Regal now.
Yeah, Regal's having difficulty finding a solution.
Sure, he's pumping himself up, but he's also giving his opponent a chance to recover.
Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Knee strike to the face.
Three.
Oh.
Four.
Regal gets the better there.
Regal isn't taking this lying down anymore.
Prime opportunity now for Regal to get some separation and gather himself.
Six.
He'll take things into the ring.
Big risk here. He may be counted out.
He might be oblivious to the count, guys.
Oh, he gets what he deserves for all that gloating.
Right between the shoulders.
Just a step ahead of Strong.
Ooh.
Tremendous win in this match.
For all those years crafting his offense, the Messiah of the Backbreaker couldn't craft a win.
NXT gets to live once again.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Elmwood Park, New Jersey, one half of the Women's Tag Team Champions, Liv Morgan!
Liv Morgan, a little unorthodox, a little unusual, but very, very talented, and always getting better.
She's nuts. I say fun.
Well, before she was fun or nuts, she was actually revered by the NXT Universe. This version of Liv Morgan... not so much.
From fabulous to untouchable.
Here comes a self-proclaimed the most beautiful woman in all of WWE.
Saxton, how many times do I have to tell you many other people make the same proclamation? This is the most beautiful woman in all of WWE. That is my unbiased opinion.
Yeah, sure it is.
And her partner, from Staten Island, New York, one half of the Women's Tag Team Champions, Carmella!
Carmella's proven herself as one of the most talented in-ring competitors, but according to Carmella and Corey, she's also the best looking.
According to many people, Cole, you clearly just don't speak to the right people.
Well, Byron told me she was best looking.
Why are you being a snitch, Michael?
Would you take the advice on whiskey from someone who's never had a drink? I don't think so. Gone are the days of moonwalking. The trash talking remains. And let's be honest, I think we were all a little bit over the dance break thing.
Hey, I miss those dance breaks.
You're the one. The future is iconic.
And Peyton Royce and Billy Kay, the IIconics.
They may or may not be two of my most trusted sources.
Oh, I believe that. Two ladies who have known each other since high school in Sydney, Australia. Now causing havoc and dismay.
And goodness gracious, they do great impressions.
They're horrible.
This is iconic. The Australian duo have taken WWE by storm and show no signs of slowing down.
Tag team rules here with Liv Morgan and Carmella. And across the ring we see Peyton Royce and Billy Kay.
These teams have built up lots of animosity towards each other, and now they have finally reached a tipping point. I would expect Bedlam to break loose here.
Will this be enough? She overcomes the pinfall attempt.
Doesn't bode well if you still can't get more than a one count by now.
Royce with a counter. Yes, boom, nice.
Has the wrist trapped, and now a series of stomps and kicks. Absolutely spiked.
DDT.
She's surely revving up, but she better put the rubber on the road already.
Mat slam
with some attitude.
Looking bad for her here. So she tags in. Is it enough here? Cover now. Oh, using the ropes. Leverage. Come on.
She is still very much in this.
Ooh, what a slap.
Oh, here we go.
Wiped out with the crossbody.
Prying their opponent's arm out. Ah, double stop right to the arm. Look at his aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
Peyton got intercepted.
There's the switch. Carmella is in.
Got to find a way to get out of this.
Oh, man. Right to the esophagus.
Tagged in. Whatever's planned here can't be good.
Split leg drop.
And she'll make the tag.
She just turned it around.
Boom! What a slap!
This is gonna be pretty. Watch this. Watch the athleticism here. She's enduring some damage. Wear down their opponent. Oh, with the heel hook stretch. My goodness. Stretched out like taffy right now.
Royce is struggling to find the upper hand.
Carmella's just doing what she pleases.
Peyton Royce turns it around.
Kick to the gut.
Boom! DDT.
Going way up high. Oh, man.
I don't really think this is the most opportune time to be
cheeky and pin her opponent right here.
And there's the kick out. She just shocked everyone in the ring.
Uh-oh. What a takedown. Fujiwara armbar.
Working to neutralize that arm.
Oh, you got that pair of that spinning leg lariat. Look at his aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
There's a supreme woman in our midst. Show some respect, WWE Universe.
Reversal on Billy Kay.
Strikes.
An incredible combination.
Oh, look at this ruthlessness in the bottom turnbuckle.
There's the tag.
Right to the back of the neck.
The switch here to Carmella.
Byron, in the world of romance, this is what we call the French kiss.
And the cover for the win!
1, 2, 3, no!
Somehow she's still in this matchup. It's unbelievable.
Here's her tag.
Liv Morgan picking up speed.
2-0-1 face breaker. Looking for the victory. Gets tagged in. Jawbreaker. You can pick up your shoulders down. This could be the one that does it for her.
Maybe not!
The breakup!
Uh-oh. Isolating the arm.
And she's using this moment to summon all of her strength.
And Billy Kay cuts her off. Elbow smash.
Stuck in the corner, trapped in the corner, and then the kicks.
That could have been it.
And a lunge bomb. Oh, right in the arm.
Things have gotten worse for Liv Morgan. She could be out of this match.
She is barely standing at this point.
This could do it.
One, two.
Oh, somehow managed to keep this match going.
How is that not three?
All measured up.
Oh, drop kick to the spine.
What a battle we are witnessing.
We're at a stage where someone's going to have to shift it into another gear.
Lewis holds it.
But in the corner now.
Oh my gosh, what impact.
Kidneys.
Golly. There's the switch. Carmella is in.
I feel a celebration coming.
Makes a cover.
Two.
Three. She did it. She picked up the victory.
These women put on quite a show. Here's another look.
This one off for the team.
Chemistry on point. Teamwork looking sharp. For my money, this is the best women's tag team around.
The era of Imperium.
A group that declares the ring is sacred.
A brutal army of mat technicians.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring at a combined weight of 440 pounds. The NXT Tag Team Champions. Fabian Aichner and Marcel Martel, Imperium!
Byron, there's no doubt that every member of this group is an elite grappler that raises each other's game.
Yeah, when you look at Imperium, you look at a group that's not here for antics or here to entertain the WWE Universe. They are simply here for pure wrestling.
It's not about entertainment. It's about winning. It's about power. It's about dominance. And Imperium has done all of that.
This group has been unstoppable.
Look at that formation. Completely in sync, like a finely tuned watch.
These guys love to fight.
Time to grit your teeth, mates.
And their opponents at a combined weight of 380 pounds, Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch.
These two men have battled each other and captured tag team gold together.
Two tough as nails superstars. Gentlemen, it's time to throw them up.
Corners, we're going to get a chance to see Fabian Aichner and Marcel Martel. And standing in their way of victory, we see Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch.
Hard to decide what team has the advantage here. It'll probably come down to who can cut the ring in half the best, who can control the pace. How insulting is that?
Spiked sit out pile driver into the cover. Before the kick out.
I can't believe the ref didn't get two here.
Beautiful dragon screw takedown. Seamless transition into the leg lock.
Right into the leg lock. He gets sent down to the floor.
The top rope all the way to the floor.
And Barthel can't find an answer for these attacks.
Yeah, Oney with impressive offense.
Two.
Put into place.
Three.
Humiliating slap.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, accompanied by Walter, representing Imperium from Dresden, Germany, weighing in at 245 pounds, Alexander Wolfe.
The WWE Universe already reaching a fever pitch upon their arrival, and we are just seconds away from a highly anticipated match. Division and plans on proving it in a matter of moments.
Oh, Byron, I know you're gonna love this. It's time to party.
One of my favorites.
And his opponent from the Isle of Samoa, weighing in at 425 pounds.
Rikishi!
Great, but the father of Jimmy and Jey Uso. The real person responsible for their tag team prowess, Saxton.
And their dance moves, too. Hey, guys, you think Rikishi would give me a dance lesson?
Absolutely not, Saxton. With any luck, you'll get a stink face.
No, no. Rikishi wouldn't do that to me.
The thing about Rikishi, guys, is he loves to have fun, right? But he's all business when the bell rings.
That's the best part. Once the music stops, Rikishi, one of the most threatening superstars in all of WWE.
Alexander Wolfe in the ring now, pressing firmly his belief that the mat is sacred.
Wolfe believes that many of his opponents have forgotten that the ring is hollow ground. And Wolf is dead set on reminding them.
With his punishing offense, I expect Wolf will jog his opponent's memory quickly.
And then we've got Rikishi, a beloved superstar who is fueled.
He's going for the pin.
Dude. And he got a near fall out of it. I'm surprised he wasn't able to kick out sooner.
As the wrist trapped, nice. And now a series of stomps and kicks.
Talk about dismantling your opponent.
to the spine. Rikishi is getting picked apart right now.
Absolutely. Wolfe is breaking his opponent down.
And his eyes are piercing through the opposition now.
Here's some free advice for Rikishi in this match. He needs to throw his weight around. The more he puts his 400 plus pounds of weight behind his attacks, the more forceful they'll become.
Well, using his size to devastate an effect is one of the things Rikishi does best, so I'm sure he'll take you up on that advice, Corey. This could do it. Wasting no time getting his shoulder up.
It'll take more than that to hold him down.
Ah, look at this, just cranking it out.
Just cranking the head.
Gotta be agonizing for the arm.
Desperate attempt here to get back on his feet.
He paid for that one.
Oh man, big time.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
Oh!
Producing a trampling.
Look at this. So ruthless.
Can he score the pin?
Maybe.
1, 2. He narrowly avoids the count.
He's determined to keep this matchup going.
He's looking a little off balance. Bad predicament right here. Rikishi is picking the competition up.
Great stuff from Rikishi. Throwing his way around and putting a ton of force behind his
attack. Alexander Wolfe with control here.
Uh-oh.
Rikishi is down and out.
Kick out. I thought it was finished off for sure.
I thought for sure this thing was wrapped up.
Well, stay in your seat. Looks like we've got a ways to go yet.
And I think to get the pinfall, you have to try that maneuver one more time.
Wolf doing all he can to protect his sacred ground.
Oh, God, that hurt. Up to the top rope now.
We're going to finish it off.
One-time bomb. Rikishi is getting picked apart right now.
Yeah, Rikishi needs to reassess his strategy.
Counter on Wolf.
And Rikishi puts a quick stop to the momentum that was building against him.
Could be the exact U-turn Rikishi needed in this match.
Setting up.
Suplex! He deflects it right back.
And Rikishi evades that.
And agile escape. Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want.
Oh man, taking it to the trachea.
This has been a colossal battle to this point. No superstar is showing signs of backing down.
We are seeing all their best on display, but it might just come down to who can take advantage of a pivotal mistake.
He's taking this to the floor now.
Oh.
3, 2.
Nice hip drop.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
Well placed kick.
Oh, man.
4.
Uncorks a thunderous chop.
5.
Oh, my God.
6.
The referee's kind of encouraging them to get in the ring.
Some attitude.
9.
And it's a double count out. Not the way we wanted to see this end.
Money, it ain't even funny.
becomes the richest man in NXT history.
Saxton, maybe you should ask Grimes for a little loan. You can update that suit game.
You know what? That's not a bad idea.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Burlington, North Carolina, weighing in at 220 pounds, Cameron Grimes.
A trainee of the Hardy Boys, who is now rich enough to buy the whole Hardy compound.
That's amazing to think about, but actually a better reason to become friends with him.
Maybe Cameron could buy somewhere for you to live so you can move out of your mom's basement.
Hey, hey. Cameron Grimes, a stock market savant, somehow made money buying coins for dogs.
That's not exactly how that works, Saxton. I'll explain later, but Cameron Grimes about to make even more money tonight when he captures the winner's purse of this match. The Bruiserweight.
And his opponent from Birmingham, England, weighing in at 205 pounds, the Bruiserweight, Pete Dunne.
Almost a sick, twisted pleasure that Dunne derives from the opportunity just to hear his opponent scream and wail in pain.
The skill set, the entitlement. Pete Dunne believes everything belongs to him, and he'll take it forcibly if he has to.
The whole WWE universe has come to know Pete Dunne by his moniker, the Bruiserweight, a name which illustrates Dunne's brutality inside the ring.
Man, being in the ring with Pete Dunne is kind of like being locked in a cage with a rabid wolverine.
But Byron, I think most men, including Dunne's opponent tonight, would prefer to face a wild animal than face the Bruiserweight.
But he's facing one tough customer in the ring, Cameron Grimes, a second-generation superstar who learned the ropes among some of the Carolina's finest teachers.
Living and breathing sports entertainment has really shaped Grimes into the athlete he is today. And now Grimes has all the handed-down wisdom a superstar needs to go straight to the moon.
Dunne's fighting him!
Forced out of the ring. Tagging this outside.
This could be good.
He didn't need that eyebrow anyway.
Great job seeing Dunne coming. What a German suplex.
Three.
Oh, the knee takes a big hit.
Gosh. Four.
Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
The stomp in every single part of his body.
Five.
You're looking for a vertical suplex.
Wait a second. A powerbomb, too?
Six.
Pete Dunne has earned a reputation as a vengeful brawler in the ring. Someone who can take a lot of punishment and then instantly return the favor. Does that play to his advantage here tonight?
I think so. Dunne can rally at a moment's notice and strike back with ferocious intensity. His opponent can never afford to count him out.
Up high.
Cover.
One. There's two. He really thought that was it.
And here we go. Locked in. It's locked in. Into an armbar. Submission move locked in.
I think he's got it. Just slipped underneath. And just like that, he's out of the hold.
this match as long and as thorough as he needs to.
He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match by countout. He slides back into the ring. Hits him with the counter. And here's a cover. And Dunne quickly kicks out.
Getting that shoulder up seemed to be pretty easy.
Oh my gosh, a follow-up moonsault slam? Off into the pin. Two. And he kicks out a hair before three.
Talk about a close call for him. Got it cinched in. This could be it.
Driver.
That's it. Cruz just ended it.
Cameron grinds with the victory. And here's another peek of the moves you saw in that match. Displayed his prowess in victory.
The Bruiserweight Pete Dunne always has more than one plan, but in the end, none of them worked tonight.
The future has arrived.
A man who bends limbs, joints, and time itself.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 192 pounds, Kushida.
Trained in both pro wrestling and MMA in Japan.
Kushida was undefeated in 8 mixed martial arts fights, and he brings those same submission skills now to WWE.
Shawn Michaels. Michaels is fed up with the disrespect he's receiving from younger members of the WWE locker room.
There was a time in HBK's career where he was brash and...
And look at this now, yes, applying the submission hold.
A lot of tension being used.
He's incomplete. How do you get out of this? Oh, look at that. What a great counter. Oh, look at this here. Arm wrench. Target in the arm now. Oh, and Kushida turns the tables.
Drop.
Oh, foot just stomping down. He thinks he has it. And he easily stops the ref's count.
He's not even close to being done yet.
Michaels possesses the relentless pursuit to win, the drive to get to the top of the mountain, and the guts to stay there. Corey, what makes the Heartbreak Kid such a difficult opponent tonight?
That intangible that can only be gained with experience. Michaels anticipates to beat you to the punch, has insane ring awareness to use every part of the ring to his advantage, and the savvy to stretch the rulebook to its limits.
Exciting offense from Kushida. He's rolling at a pace of 88 miles per hour.
He gets the better of HBK.
Continuing to attack the neck. Across the top rope.
Good timing with that reversal. Leg sweep.
Nice.
Into the cover. He kicks out before the count starts.
How'd he do that? Oh, man, that was nasty.
They weren't that good looking anyway.
HBK connects.
You better believe Mike.
Here it comes.
Oh, man. Mr. WrestleMania.
Sweet chin music.
Boom. HBK got all of it.
Try to end it.
One, two, three.
Shawn Michaels gets the win. Here's a few clips from the last match for us.
Here is your winner, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels!
Well, you can't really argue with a win like that, guys. You can tell this guy was fired up from the moment the bell rang.
He definitely had the motivational advantage in this match.
Look who's here! The cream of the crop has arrived!
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Sarasota, Florida, weighing in at 239 pounds, Macho Man Randy Savage!
One of the all-time greats, truly a once-in-a-lifetime talent. The Macho Man, Randy Savage. Incredible, incredible superstar, Hall of Famer, legend.
That's right. There's only one Macho Man, Randy Savage.
You are looking at the personification of unrivaled intensity. And the Macho Man, Randy Savage, as intense as he is charismatic. Time for a grappling lesson.
Well, this is more than a lesson, Cole. This is a master class.
And his opponent from Sacramento, California, weighing in at 225 pounds, Timothy Thatcher.
Well, this guy loves a good fight, and his cracked teeth are proof.
Oh, like a dentist's nightmare.
Nothing pretty, nothing fancy about Timothy Thatcher. Simply a man on a mission to inflict pain.
Is Timothy Thatcher out here, no doubt, with a game plan to cause his competition about as much pain as he possibly can with his particular style of offense.
You know, yeah, Thatcher is always prepared to prove the superiority of his Thatch-as-Thatch-can style. That in-your-face, gnarly technical style that he takes absolute pride and delight in.
This matchup will not be pretty, especially if Thatcher finds himself desperate to prove a point.
And on the other end, make no mistake about it, Savage is legit. But my question is, will he be able to stay focused and not get distracted?
Up high!
Wow! Cross body! And shoulders are down. Kick out at one.
And those kickouts are only going to get harder.
And setting him up. Oh, I need him. Yes.
That's going to hurt.
Ooh, ruthless striking.
Relentless assault from the Macho Man.
From the top.
What a takedown. Fujiwara on bar.
Going after the arm.
Fujiwara on bar. Incredible pressure.
Suplex.
He's getting a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Ooh, treading all over their opponent.
Macho Man able to come back. He's getting a little battered now.
Savage avoids damage.
And the electricity of this moment is coursing through his veins.
Savage thinking big. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Oh, just bounce that face like a basketball.
Now look at this aggression, just pure brutality.
Oh, easy.
This is what you call high risk, high reward.
Perched up top. Diving knee drop.
He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
Cover. And he breaks the count. Quickly.
Channeling his energy to stay in this matchup.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Oh, enough already.
Oh, what a knee. Boom, right the button. Everything working against Thatcher now.
You bring the intensity like Randy Savage.
Thatcher showing great instinct.
The sleeper locked in. The sleeper hold is locked in.
This could be it.
Cocaine clutch. Nowhere to go, but there is a way to break it. He could do it here.
One, two.
He gets the shoulder up at two.
That was a long two count there.
Evades their offense.
Oh, ooh, knee left.
Somebody better check his nose.
Station from Savage.
Two. An emphatic victory. These guys feel no love for each other. Here's another look.
This is what you get when you have complete confidence and control of the situation.
Is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 290 pounds, the NXT Champion, the Animal, Batista!
We can list this man's accolades all day long. WWE Champion, a Royal Rumble winner, a man who has main evented WrestleMania, and now Batista simply demands that the WWE Universe give him what he wants. Success both in the ring and in Hollywood, which is insane because for some reason the WWE Universe has never appreciated Batista quite enough.
Well, no question about it, Batista will demand the respect of the WWE Universe right here tonight.
Dismantled the competition in WWE. No one is safe when the Animal is on the hunt. The entire locker room is on notice when Batista enters the arena. His biggest motivation is leaving a trail of annihilation behind him.
And in the opposing corner, the D.O. Double G, Road Dogg Jesse James.
A tremendous athlete in his own right, but even more talent.
Can he do it here? You have to think this battle is starting to weigh down on him.
Oh, an elbow drop for added measure.
Oh, drop.
Into the corner. This can't be good. Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
Oh, an
nasty stomp to finish it off.
And Road Dogg is being controlled here.
Road Dogg needs to win
the title. Oh, and he doesn't connect.
Suplex.
And that's a cover. Getting the shoulder up before two.
Not even a near fall there.
Just mounted with punches and not right to the gut.
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Locks in the gut wrench.
Batista is out of his cage.
Call animal control. Batista's loose.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Oh, relentless.
God. Enough already.
Batista has always relied on his tremendous strength. Corey, will that be enough to get the job done tonight?
Well, many say that's why Batista dominated WWE, but he developed new tools to supplement that strength. Tonight, he should mix his power with his MMA background, which will add even more devastation to his joint and limb manipulation.
Punch connects. Rear chin lock, and now just rapid-fire punches.
Going up top.
Way too long. Inner contact. There's two. Narrowly avoids the pinfall.
Only had a little room to get the shoulder up and somehow did.
Knee drop.
Nasty. So precise.
Road Dogg putting his money with him.
Pump handle applied.
Victory nearly in hand for Road Dogg.
Resiliency by Batista to kick out there, but you gotta wonder if that was his last run.
Will that be the last opportunity? Is there still enough left in these men?
Oh, nasty stop to finish it off.
And now Batista's being dismantled.
The animal has got to turn the aggression on to survive.
Stomp in the leg.
Consider that a harsh lesson
for control. What a kick.
From behind. Back suplex.
He's got to defend. This could be it.
Two.
Yeah. He doesn't get the three.
I cannot believe what I'm seeing right now.
No one can.
Straight punch. Nothing fancy.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want.
Powerbomb.
He's absorbing some tough hits now.
There's been plenty of back.
Uh-oh. Nice job getting to the ropes.
Really had no choice.
Spear. Incredible. And this has got to be it.
One. Two.
Kicking out in time.
I didn't think we'd see a kick out there.
Batista gets warded off.
Right to the ribs.
I have to say, I feel like we are just one move away from claiming a winner in this one.
One more move or one more misstep, either one can do it.
What's he preparing for?
Power slam. Here he goes for the win.
Two.
Kicks out.
Somehow, someway, he is still in this. Road Dogg knows what he needs to end this.
Into the gut. Pump handle applied.
Will Batista recover?
Two. That's it. The blood and sweat put into this match. Well worth it.
How about another look at some of the highlights? We'll be right back.
victory where you really have to weigh the costs against the benefits.
With a win like this, things have got to taste a little bittersweet right about now.
Actually, Saxton, I imagine the win tastes a lot more like pennies.
Well, the disciple has arrived. One of the most dynamic athletes in WWE, now under the learning tree of the Messiah.
The following contest is a four-man battle royal and is for the NXT North American Championship. Introducing the challenger from Melbourne, Australia, weighing in at 213 pounds, Murphy!
Of Murphy's career, he found success winning the NXT Tag Team Championship and Cruiserweight titles, but in the years since, lost direction until the Messiah.
Made a huge difference in Murphy's career as the Messiah.
Introducing the challenger from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, The Rock!
Well, he's the most electrifying man in sports entertainment. He's taken WWE by storm.
If you
Whoa, this ain't sing along with The Rock, Saxton.
I thought it was.
Here comes Cesaro. The Swiss cyborg has arrived. Hey, we've said it before and we'll say it again. Pound for pound, Cesaro is the strongest man in all of WWE.
And introducing the challenger from Lucerne, Switzerland, weighing in at 232 pounds, Cesaro!
You know, Corey, Cesaro had one of the great matches in NXT history.
Two out of three falls versus Sami Zayn. Some would argue that match put NXT on the map.
I was there, I called it, and I would argue that that match put NXT on the map.
He is the NXT North American Champion, the Ultimate Warrior!
Still running and gunning! The frenzy will
up until Warrior's hands are raised in victory.
Man, does the Ultimate Warrior ever run out of energy?
Look at the Ultimate Warrior, one of the all-time greats, fired up here tonight.
North American Championship being contended for in this Battle Royal match with Murphy, The Rock, Cesaro, and Ultimate Warrior.
And now, don't be surprised if everyone's first objective was to gang up on the champion and get them tossed out immediately, so we're guaranteed a new title holder.
The champion is in a terrible position tonight.
What a right hook.
Left side down. Like being manhandled by a bear.
And Warrior moves.
Oh, look at that torture their opponent. Uh-oh, this isn't going to be good. Oh, man.
Spiked him.
Elbow drop right on point.
Here we go. This is going to be nasty.
Sit down.
Spin kick to the midsection.
Warrior counters.
There's some power behind that punch.
And this one not have a pleasant ending.
Trying to fight their way out of harm's way. Elbows to the jaw.
Right hook. My goodness, did you hear that, Chop?
Great display of strength with the suplex.
The challenger's looking shaken.
Enough already.
Carefully, Cesaro's caught with a reversal.
What a punch.
What a punch.
He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
Great wherewithal on the counter.
Back and forth from these competitors.
Leg sit up powerbomb.
Set up for the side rushing leg sweep.
Boom. It's okay. They weren't that pretty anyway.
Ooh-wee.
Tagged with a punch.
Face first with a waistlock takedown.
Ooh, well measured.
There it is, the people's punch.
Ripped over and a snap suplex.
Turned that one around.
Each superstar trying to stay a step ahead.
The challenger's looking shaken.
All the way over.
He reverses it.
Hoist it up.
All the way up.
Still up.
Squatting too, my gosh.
Wow.
Murphy has been eliminated.
Launched up high. Backbreaker.
Punch right in the head.
Corner, unleashing the strikes.
We'll be looking for the neutralizer.
The neutralizer! The title's in jeopardy here.
I think the paradigm has shifted.
The WWE Universe is pouring more fuel on his fire right now.
Just thrown away.
Oh, man, you can see he is feeling it now.
Counter by the Rock. Oh, snap there. Followed by an elbow. The challenger not looking good right now.
Yeah, this fatal four-way has certainly taken its toll, Michael.
Oh, and he stays ahead of Warrior. Right to the kidneys from behind. Hooked up. Oh, shit breaker.
The adrenaline is pumping, and the WWE Universe is on his side.
The Ultimate Warrior has been eliminated.
Where you want to be right now, just carried like a ragdoll here. Oh, caught him in the head.
Rock moves in the nick of time.
Rock with the arm clutch into the
DDT.
We've seen this before. The Rock setting up.
There it is. You can have a new champion.
A possible elimination in progress.
Oh, you can take this.
The Rock just etched his name in the history book tonight.
Well, it wasn't literally fatal, but it was pretty close. Take a look.
Here is your winner and the new NXT North American Champion.
For this superstar, or should I say, for the new champion.
We really are looking at a new era, Cole. Soak it in.